house.
All aboard!
Well, y'all coming?
Where?
Why do you not follow us? This is the power.
Children, all in their pajamas and nightgowns. We sang Christmas carols and ate candy with nougat sandwiches as white as snow. We drank hot chocolate as thick and rich as melted chocolate bars.
Mountains turned to hills, the hills turned to snow-covered lakes. We crossed a barren desert on ice. Great polar ice cap lights appear in the distance. They look like lights of straight ocean liners sailing on a frozen sea.
Closer to the center of the North Pole, we slow to a crawl.
street to Santa's helpers. And when the Polar Express could go no further, we stopped and the conductor let us out.
Thank you.
soon as we were back inside the Polar Express, the other children asked to see the bell. When I reached into my pocket, the only thing I felt was a hole. I had lost the silver bell from Santa's sleigh. Let's hurry outside and look for it, one of the other children said. But the train gave a sudden lurch and started moving. We were on my way home. It broke my heart to lose the bell. When the train reached my house, I sadly left the other children. Mother said,
"Oh, that's too bad."
"Yes, it's broken."
"When I had shaken the bell, my parents had not heard a sound. At one time, most of my friends could hear the bell, but as the years passed, it fell silent for all of them. Even Sarah found one Christmas she could no longer hear the sweet sound that I've grown older. And the bell still rings for me, as it does for all who truly believe.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming to see our Polar Express show. And now it's time for the curtain call. Let's hear it for all of the pajama children on the train. Let's hear it for Mrs. Sonica's class. Let's hear it for Mrs. Stanley's class. Let's hear it for Mrs. Zook's class. Let's hear it for our honor choir elves from the North Pole. Let's hear it for our choir reindeer from the North Pole. Let's hear it for Santa's